Hi everyone, it's Janis here. As I have been managing teams of people, I had discovered that work gets done much quicker and better if I explain to people why it needs to be done. So instead of just saying do this or change that, it was helpful to explain why some particular job needs to be done. What is interesting when you explain to your team why we do what we do is that it gets team involved in the process of achieving the team's objectives. And the team will often come up with even better solutions than you had imagined, because they are the ones who are building it. I remember when I was working on a mobile game and I asked the developer to integrate a certain feature in the game. I also explained why we need this feature, that with this new feature, I'm expecting to achieve a certain goal. After I explained my why, the developer proposed alternative solution that would help us as a team to achieve the goal quicker. We scrapped my original idea and went with developer's suggestion, and it was the right choice. We developed new solution quicker and it was also more functional. Today, we'll take a look at the book called Start With Why by Simon Sinek. So let's dive in. Number one, if you want to motivate others, you have to captivate them. Many organizations and individuals follow old strategies of rewards and penalties. So in order to increase the performance, people would be incentivized with the bonuses to perform better, and those who underperform would get penalties. This is the old carrot and stick principle, and while it seems to work, there are better ways to get your team to perform even better. Good leaders and managers inspire people to take action because they know why, and they recognize a deeper meaning. Of course, salesperson can be motivated by ever higher commission payments, but knowing that business is providing clients with outstanding solutions or service will make the salesperson to perform even better. Number two, golden circle. If you want to understand where the real motivation and meaning comes from, you have to understand the golden circle. Golden circle is formed from three circles, one around another. It starts with why right in the middle, then how around it, and what at last. Every organization knows their what. These are the products that they sell or services that they provide. Some organizations know their how. These are the things that make them special or set them apart from the competition. Only few organizations know why they do what they do. Why is not about making money. That is a result of what and how. Why is a purpose, cause, or belief. It's the very reason organization exists in the first place. Number three, communicate the golden circle inside out. Everyone is always quick when it comes to deciding what to do next, what projects to tackle, or what tasks to complete. And some people will also tell you how to get it done, but very few people will know why it needs to be done in the first place. This results in many things being created but not used. Companies just produce a lot of stuff that later just sits in the warehouse. That is why it's important to understand the why before going ahead and deciding what and how. And this doesn't just apply to businesses and corporations. This applies to every individual on this world. You might want the education, which is your what. The how is to go to the university and get a degree. But have you decided why you want it? Nowadays, people are often going with the flow. They do things just because everyone else is doing them. So someone might say, all my classmates went to the university, so I went as well. But that is not a great way to approach your life. Life must be lived with a purpose and meaning. That is the reason why so many people find themselves stuck in life, because they didn't do things for themselves, but instead followed somebody else. Number four, when you start with why, you'll be more stable. I know how hard it is to keep going when going gets tough. And if you don't know why you're doing what you're doing, then you'll quickly give up. Some time ago, I was creating content that was targeted towards freelancers. It was a great niche and I was excited about it. I knew that I want to create content and how I'll do it, but I didn't have a clear why. And while why is not stopping you to take action, it will soon become apparent. 3 months later, I was completely exhausted. And that's when I asked myself the magic question. Why do I create content for freelancers? And for days, I couldn't come up with the answer. And I also couldn't produce any more content. So I stopped the project and decided to do something else. It was only later that I realized that I had started without understanding the reasons of why I wanted to do it. Number 5, excited people are the most powerful resource. I have worked on multiple projects, and people are the most valuable resource. Of course, it's important for you to be productive and get things done. But to really move projects forward, you need people. People will be ones who will be driving your operations. Programmers, artists, video editors, assistants, etc. And you will have two ways to motivate them. One with rewards and penalties, and other option is to get them inspired so that they're interested to achieve the goals. The first option might work for a bit, but the second option will outlast the first one, and it will also be more productive. Number 6, the hardest part is to keep the why alive. Life is moving on, and things are constantly changing. This, however, means that you will constantly need to be aware of what is happening with your why and keep it alive. It's not just enough to discover your why. It needs to be communicated through your team and organization. The problem with many businesses is that they have their why and they stick with it. Then they start making money and numbers are taking over the why. It is no more how do we serve our clients better, but how much money did we make? And money starts watering down the why. To make sure that this doesn't happen, the why needs to be continuously communicated throughout the team and reinforced while making decisions. I hope that this video gives a good overview of the importance of why and how all decisions in your life should start with understanding your why. If you enjoyed this video, make sure that you hit that like button below, and I'll see you guys in another episode. If you want to manage your time better, have more structure in your life, and achieve your goals, make sure you check out my time planning application. You can set goals and track progress towards them, create time blocks and build your own daily structure, as well as log your time and measure your performance. Best of all, it's totally free, so press here to check it out right now. I'm working on new videos every day. So be sure you subscribe so you don't miss my next episode.